आज हम इस वीडियो में डिस्कस करेंगे हाउ डू एसिड एंड बेस रिएक्ट विद मेटल्स। ये एनसीईआरटी चैप्टर 2 की एक्टिविटी 2.3 है। सो व्हेनेवर एन अ मेटल रिएक्ट विद एन एसिड इट विल बी फॉर्मिंग अ सॉल्ट एंड इट विल रिलीज हाइड्रोजन गैस। दिस इज जस्ट लाइक अ सिंगल डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन चैप्टर 1। सो let us see this activity. Single displacement reaction, the reaction in which more reactive element displaces the less reactive element. For this experiment we required zinc granules. We have taken this zinc granules in a china dish, then an acid in a conical flask. The next step is to add zinc granules into acid. So what happened when metal react with an acid? You can see there. Bubbles are formed. That is, hydrogen gas is released. This is a very highly vigorous reaction. So it forms salt and hydrogen gas is released in the reaction, which is clearly visible through these bubbles which are formed in the reaction. Now in the activity, zinc is reacting with H2SO4 forming ZnSO4 and release of hydrogen gas. When this hydrogen gas is passed into the soap solution, so see this setup. So when from the delivery tube the hydrogen gas released is passed into the soap solution, it forms a soap bubble in which hydrogen gas is trapped, and when we bring burning candle near to it, it bursts with a pop sound. So in this reaction, this is an important point and many times CBSE exam mein pucha jata hai ki how the hydrogen gas detected in this reaction. So whenever it is passed through soap solution, it form a soap bubble in which hydrogen gas is trapped. When we bring burning candle near to it, it bursts with a pop sound. And now you will repeat this activity with number of acids. For example, you can repeat this with HCl, then you can repeat this activity with HNO3 and CH3COH. Now what will be the difference is that as H2SO4, HCl and HNO3 are strong acid, large amount of hydrogen gas is released, but in case of acetic acid, bubbles are there but they are present in small amount. So in the activity 2.3 it is asked what is your observation. So in all these cases hydrogen gas is released, but in case of acetic acid, small amount of gas is released, or we can say small number of bubbles formed in comparison to the sulfuric acid. Now activity 2.4 is also on the same basis. What happened when metal is added into a base? So again it forming salt and release hydrogen gas just like acid also. So for example, Zn plus NaOH, it will be forming Na2ZnO2. And how this gas is detected? Again the similar method. When we pass this gas into soap solution, it form a bubble in which gas is trapped, and when we bring burning candle near to it, it bursts with soap pop sound. Now we have to balance this equation. This is 2, here we will write an 2. So we can say acid or a base, when react with a metal, it always forms salt and hydrogen gas. Now the question arises that is this reaction is given by all metals? Kya sabhi metal yehi same reaction denge? Then answer is no. Why? So answer lie in the reactivity series. As we know, reactivity series is arrangement of metals in decreasing order from top to bottom. Now those metals which just lie before hydrogen is able to displace the hydrogen, but those which lie beyond hydrogen will not able to displace hydrogen in the reaction. As we know, whenever a metal react with an acid, for example H2SO4, now metal will displace hydrogen. So which metal will displace hydrogen? Which is more reactive than hydrogen. For example, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sodium, zinc, iron, aluminium, all these metal can form similar, that is salt, and release hydrogen gas. But what happened if we take copper metal? Then there will be no reaction. So, answer of the question that no, all metals do not react in the similar way.